recording immediately. So, ladies and gentlemen, the sacred, very sacred audience that, you know, follows, listens, and participates in the Sean Cross channel, the Anatomy Podcast, Under the Skin, and if you even checked out my vocal covers as of recently, you know what we're doing here. This is going to be, what is it? This is episode, I think, 17 or 18 now, which is really cool. Like, we've made it a long way. And currently for me, it is 6:18 p.m. It is the 23rd of February. We have the entirety of Slaughter the False Prophet with us here tonight.
There we go. All right.
Yes. And now he's on. And what's really cool is we have a familiar face coming back. If you guys remember Alex Savigny from the various projects that he has participated and contributed to, including Litterbox Massacre, The White Bear Project, Divine Destruction, and of course, Slaughter the False Prophet. Very happy to be having him come back. Like, it's actually cool that we're having reoccurring guests now. But tonight's discussion will definitely be promoting that of Alec Maleficus Lopez, Alex Savigny, Alexander, and Dakota's efforts in Slaughter the False Prophet. And this is a really cool project that is emerging from the deep, shadowy depths. And like, all I can say is that I am more than happy to be joining them along the ride as they get everything together for their first couple chapters as an official band. So, gentlemen, right off the bat, wanted to kind of ask how you're doing and if you're excited for the session tonight.
Hell yeah, dude. Pumped.
Hell yeah.
I've been pumped.
Yeah, the thing is, too, what's really, really just freaking cherry on top for the session is Maleficus himself, the vocalist for Slaughter the False Prophet, has been following the podcast for quite some time now. And we've been in talks recently discussing what will be Slaughter the False Prophet's Facebook community, as well as other collaborations, which really excited about, to say the least. Getting this mug, this freaking face out there into the world whilst also promoting such a awesome project. So as we dive in to the first half of the Anatomy Podcast, we're talking about the people. We're talking about the fractions that make up the whole that is Slaughter the False Prophet. So whoever wants to go first, basically tell me a little bit about yourself, where you grew up, and we'll go from there.
All right. I'm Maleficus. I'm the vocalist of Slaughter the False Prophet. I am the starter of this band. I started this band back in sophomore year of high school, basically on just a dream of being a total misanthropist. And,
right.
Dude, I'm digging the liquid death.
Yeah, cheers.
I drink that shit every single time I got
religiously.
I drink that shit.
Murder your thirst. But you were saying...
I started this band completely from sophomore year. I'm digging Alex in here. There you look sexy.
Cool. Oh, thanks, man.
I fucking love this guy. But I started it sophomore again, and I was moving forward throughout life until eventually I ended up in graduating from
yes.
Big Spring High School over here. Wasn't a good school, promise you that. Afterwards, I got into a couple bands that over here that I just wish were a lot more harder and a lot more brutal and punishing.
Right.
Especially to lyric-wise the human condition. And,
yes.
And from there, I moved into online projects. I've only been in one outside of Slaughter the False Prophet, but that was a terrible project that I don't want to speak about on here.
Okay.
That shit happened in that project.
Fair enough.
But then I met a man from a band called Moon Presence, and since I was a Dark Souls jack off myself, I kept following that band. I was the biggest fanboy of that band, and I got friends with vocalist Darian Dilemmi. Shout out
yes.
to that guy.
Darian, hell yeah.
And after that, I started talking to him a little bit, and I asked him, like, if he knew any good producers for music because I'm basically struggling over here getting music because I just wanted to make fucking music and go out. And that's when I met the sexy boy here, the main man, Alex Sevigny.
Yep.
Aw, thanks, man. I love you too.
Love you. I love you.
And yeah, to say the least, we all know a little bit about Alex Sevigny. If you want to, be sure to check out our podcast episode prior to the recording of this episode, because we had a blast talking with this guy as well. But of course, Maleficus, you were saying.
From there, I didn't know shit about recording, but How Forsaken was recorded. I sent vocals first, stupidly, and he made it so fucking ferocious that I fell in love with this man. Fell in love with him from the first recording. And I did like two songs of that, but then afterwards, after learning about recording and processing and everything, I'm like, man, I might as well make it easier for the guy. And I fucked everything up at first. But from there on, I started recording to his songs and everything, and just But from there, it just skyforwarded from there, and it was fun. It was great. I still am learning everything to this day. I didn't think music would be that expensive, but holy shit!
Oh yeah, especially for that spicy quality, man. Like, you gotta. It's a big investment.
I expected the EP to be done like throughout like 6 months, but holy shit, dude! I did not expect music to be this expensive just getting into it.
Yeah, and the thing is too, when you're working with someone like Alex Sevigny who knows what the fuck he's doing, like, naturally it's gonna take a little bit more time.
How talented the guy is, I'm like, holy shit, he is so fucking affordable, man. He is so fucking affordable for a cheap bastard like me.
Right, seriously. But yeah, by all means, thank you for that first intro, you know, dialogue, just getting us introduced to the man behind the corpse paint and all that shit. Cause...
Oh my gosh. The corpse paint, it completely makes me feel different whenever I wear it personally. It makes me feel like Maleficus has come out.
Yeah, honestly, this is same for me. And that's kind of like my whole branding now. I'm just like, I'm kind of a YouTuber who does reactions, but they're reactions. And then, you know, just corpse paint in that cross really just changes everything to me. And I think that's really, it's a visual aesthetic. You know what I mean? Like,
mostly reactions to, like, from what I've noticed, a lot of black and deathcore type people.
Yeah.
Black metal type people, I think, if you could.
Right.
Just with murder involved.
Right. Seriously. But, moving on, because, you know, covering Maleficus, thank you for letting us know a little bit about yourself. We have Dakota and Alexander. Now, whoever wants to start out first, obviously you are brand new to this podcast, just like Maleficus. So by all means, take a little bit of time, introduce yourself, how you got into the band, how you got into music, that type of thing.
Appreciate it. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Oh,
hell yeah. All right. For sure. So, been rocking percussion since I was 15. I'm 25 now, just barely hit the 10-year mark. From West Texas over here, pretty close to Maleficus right now.
Right.
An hour away. Heck yeah. Started off in whatever I could get my hands on. I mean, by the time I got a drum set, I was on stage just playing local shows within a month. It was horrendous, terrible, but the experience was something.
You told me all those stories, dude.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't trade that experience for anything. Had a project going for about 8 years, Nightmare Canvas. At the end of it, we ended up moving to like the whole corpse paint thing and became a lot more atmospheric black and metal. Started off as a thrash project, but I mean, right. I was young, so I was like super into Lamb of God and like Dolly. It was impossible for me to play, so the heavier shit I listened to, I'm like, man, I gotta write within my limitations. But now I'm sitting here playing this fucking Infinite Annihilator type shit that fucking Alex over here has written. I'm like, son of a bitch. But I mean, pulled in my chops.
I get that from drummers. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, shit. It's cool that my chops are where they're at now. It's where I can do it. It's been a long ride, but yeah, I've just been stoked to be a part of the journey. I got everything ready to rock and roll and tour, man. So
dude,
once we get ready for that chapter, I'm ready to rock. Shit, we can even throw, if we have to, we can even throw a hitch on my van and rock that bitch if we need
exactly.
to.
Oh, dude, exactly.
I nominated.
Yeah, I have a little experience doing that. Went on like two or three week runs with my prior project, and then right before this I was in Plague of Torment, which was something I did everything except the guitars and vocals on. Composed all the bass, everything else. We've got a little bit out online. I've got like 8 songs unreleased. Just fell into some beef with my partner because it was just a two-man project, and then we had contracted a vocalist for, you know, specific songs, but that kind of fell on its face, so I've got a bunch of stuff there. But anyway, there's some stuff out that, you know, everyone's getting paid for as it gets plays, but really stoked to be a part of this. Really stoked to be getting back on the road. I haven't been on the road in probably like, I'm 25 now. Yeah, it's been like 3 years. So.
Shit, yeah. And that's the thing too, like just right off the bat, breaking down to service level, when, you know, the likes of Maleficus, who's still considerably young, he's younger than me, which is still crazy. You know, people like Maleficus, people like Donovan from Disembodied Tyrant, who is fucking 16.
Or is he 17?
He's like 16 or 17 now. That's all I know. And the
fuck?
Yeah, seriously. Like sooner or later, we'll have 12-year-olds in bands, and they'll be like, "Well, we definitely cannot have you go on tour, but you're a good vocalist. Keep on working on that until you're Alexander, at least 16 or 18."
But you got to start them out young, man.
Conditioning. No, seriously. But hands down, when you have someone a part of the team who's already experienced with touring, who's experienced with just kind of operating that whole machine that is touring and getting out on the road, that is really important. But of course, also because you got, you know, the chops and you know how to drum the way that you do. Because I know that hearing Rituals of Sin and Forsaken and, you know, the EP and the album, and later into time, it's going to be heavy. It's going to be heavy, and Alexander is here to absolutely slaughter, hint, hint, that drum set.
Yes, sir.
But, Mr. Dakota, you are up next, sir. Tell me a little bit about yourself as a person, basically where you grew up, how you got into music, and how the fuck you got into an awesome band like this. You know what I mean?
Well, honestly, this is kind of a little, I'm going to shorten the story a little bit because there's a lot to cover.
Right. Okay.
But I come from Oregon, which is, where are you at again? May I ask?
Oh, I'm in Tennessee.
Oh, okay. So yeah,
but I used to live in Arizona. Oregon. Okay, cool.
Okay. No, I live in Alabama. So.
Oh, okay. Cool.
But
well, we're a lot closer than you think.
Yeah, I know, right? Long story short, I have been through hell and back. Pun not intended. Whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
I've been through, because I'm disabled, and so I've been through a group home. I've been through. Well, long story short, I've been through hell and back, and how I started music was 10 years ago to, I think, December,
mm-hmm.
20, like, around, because I got my first guitar when I was, like, 18.
Right.
My dad bought it for me, because I kept my grades up. Kids, stay in school.
Stay in school.
But, the most non-metal thing to say. But, I started learning guitar, and when I started, I was so bad. Like, oh my God, it was terrible.
Everybody is at first.
I'm all right though. Like, I chug a lot. I like the just down tempo, just brutality of fucking brutal. But I guess how I met Alec, or what you would call a Maleficus, I met him through my best friend Dayton Turner, which is in the Agony Prop. No, Agony Throne. Anyway, Agony Throne, and he introduced me to Alec, aka Maleficus.
Yeah.
I can't remember if it was like 2 years ago today or whatever. Like it was
was like about 3 or 2 years from what I remember.
Yeah. Anyway, long story short, me and Alec Maleficus, we became like homies right after we talked.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
And like, we were like really like close. Yeah, we're like butt buddies or some shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'll suck his dick, he'll give me head, you know what I'm saying? Like, shit.
Oh yeah, you know it.
Oh yeah, daddy. But no, like, honestly, like, I feel like me and Alec and Alec 78 and now Alexander, I feel like we all, this is a LA, lot of Alec.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
There's a lot.
Three Alex, one Dakota.
Yeah. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, no. Let's not get that super parent game thing with black guys and shit. What the fuck? Oh, God. This is not going to be a gangbang, I promise.
Dude,
but
man.
No. Where was that? Oh yeah, I gotta lost track what I was saying.
No, you're good. You're good.
So I guess me and Dayton and Alec, we became like really close. And I think what group was it on Alec? What was it like? I think it's a deathcore vocal thing.
It was the Extreme Vocal Institute on Facebook. I just kept posting vocal videos constantly just to get promotion. Mm-hmm. And yeah. I remember Dayton Turner giving me a really positive comment.
Yeah.
I checked him out. Like, I clicked on his profile picture, tells me all his posts. Sounded like a fucking grizzly bear. He sounds grizzly like bear. like dead ass. He sounds like a grizzly bear whenever he screams. And
top-tier Pornhub material.
Oh
yeah,
shit.
Top tier Pornhub material.
exactly.
And from there, I talked to him more, and I kept wanting to do music with the guy because holy shit, he's so fucking good.
Right.
And from then, I remember him talking to me like he was one of my friends, and that's when we got introduced to Dakota here.
Yes.
We were all just doing like a friend group on Facebook thing.
And yes.
Randomly, Dakota was at it involved.
Cool. Yeah.
And that's how I met Dakota.
Sick. And Dakota, are you going to be you're going to be taking on rhythm guitar, right?
Yes.
Okay. So now I understand that for sure. And yeah, I mean, Alex, you can talk, Savinia, you can talk a little bit about yourself if you want, but people already know who the fuck you are if they listen to this podcast. Yeah.
I probably heard quite extensively about me from the last episode, but basically been playing guitar my whole life. Writing a lot of deathcore over the years, and I've been super lucky to get in touch with a lot of great vocalists and musicians over the years and built kind of a platform for myself. And I'm super thankful for Darian for sending Alec my way, because working on this project has been like a fucking blast, and definitely some of the darkest shit I've ever written in my life.
Right.
And every time I write something new and darker, our Maleficus is just like, yo, that's sick, dude. And it just like fuels the darkness for the new stuff.
Right. No, that's really cool.
Been a great outlet, honestly.
Yeah. And okay. So like, obviously the last time we had you on, you mentioned, and we were promoting primarily only about 4 to 6 projects, but give me a rough estimate on how many fucking bands you are working on right now. Cause holy like shit. You just keep on surprising me, man.
Yeah. I like to keep busy. Like I'm working with at least 4 or 5 right now, like on a weekly basis,
right.
Month to month, I guess that could be like closer to 10.
Yeah.
Cause yeah, like my own bands, I think we're all constantly doing stuff too, working on stuff.
Yeah.
And then there's all like client work and all that on top. So like month to month, yeah, like at least 10 projects, at least 10 bands that I'm working with.
I can't even imagine ongoing. Like I've written so far about maybe 62 like songs worth of lyrics, and I'm trying to compact them all. I can't even imagine, man. Like obviously it would just be me playing guitar and getting into instrumentals a lot more, which I might be doing pretty soon. I might be getting into drumming and doing bass because I like the grittier parts of the music, and I want to handle and I want to command that. I want to grab it by the balls and just have that be what I'm
best
doing.
Best feeling in the world, bro. Best feeling in the world.
Seriously. So,
like, grab it by the balls.
Grab it by the balls. But yeah, like, seriously, but like, it's really incredible to know that, you know, for one, we've had people like that on the podcast before, but now they're fucking coming back because they keep on doing more bands. It's crazy. It's very surreal.
Eventually, with all the indie bands, you're gonna have Alec Sevigny on every episode.
Seriously,
you're gonna need to have him involved more in the band. No, not the band, the channel.
I mean, right. I'm down, I guess.
Well,
I'll come back.
There we go. But with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to conclude the first half of the Anatomy Podcast session, being episode 17, with that of a very, like, very dark, very gritty, very just bleh, like fucking band being Slaughter the False Prophet. The band you see right below when you type in Slaughter, because there are not that many bands in the scene that have the first word Slaughter, thank goodness. So
Slaughter to Prevail, let's ignore them.
Exactly. Yeah. Right? So got Slaughter to Prevail and then Slaughter the False Prophet. Boom, there you go. You're like right under the Kingpin Deathcore band from Russia. So as we migrate into the second half of the session, we talk about the band itself. And obviously, this will be more or less covered by Alec Sevigny and that of Maleficus himself. So, and you know, just got all the juicy questions that y'all always hear on these podcast sessions, whether you be among the eight that follow the official podcast on Spotify or listen to it on any other streaming service or watch the actual YouTube upload videos on the YouTube channel. You get what I mean. Y'all are here for a reason. So, first question would be, how did you guys end up coming up with the name Slaughter the False Prophet?
Oh, God. Now, this is going to be weird. I remember being a fucking Christian boy when I was a kid. And I remember reading a Bible about the Revelation shit, whatever the fuck's happening, and saying, right, like, a false prophet here to deceive the people. Dead ass. I was like, eh, fuck that guy. So then I made the name Slaughter the False Prophet just off of that itself.
Right. Are you saying we're a Christian band?
Yeah, no. Hell no.
Could be misconstrued.
But the imagery could be proven otherwise. Just
true. Yeah.
Make truth.
There's like dead ass, like a giant upside down cross in the logo itself. And,
yeah, for real. And I mean, yeah. Do you remember, like, what false prophet in the Bible it was based upon?
It was on the one that was to completely deceive man itself.
Okay.
But now with everything that's happening, I say that every government higher official is a false prophet.
Exactly.
Because I say butcher all of them first.
Yeah.
Slaughter
for better terms. Yeah. By all means and measures. And what I like is that so far this year, I think I have hosted, as of now, the two most controversial lyrical content bands in the underground heavy music scene. You got that of Nithful and you got that of Slaughter the False Prophet. One is going after the Bible and the other, well, that's going after something that is very, very real in the world. And of course, in due time, we will be covering the lyrical contents of that big effort. You know, that's all I'm going to say. Because by all means, we definitely want to keep that under wraps. But moving on, if anything, let's see. What should we be expecting this year as vague as possible from Slaughter the False Prophet?
A fucking EP, that's for sure.
A fucking EP, let's go. So
a long one or a short one?
I would say like a shorter kind of one for now. But definitely there are going to be a lot more fucking songs to come, especially within
the right.
Especially now that I'm getting like a better job within the logo field itself.
Exactly. And that's really how bands usually start, So that's kind of that's a good start, is getting an EP out into the world. And here's a question concerning that EP. The songs that we have so far, because I know the people are going to want to know this, are these singles so far standalone singles, or are they going to be involved in the EP itself?
Oh, they will be involved. They will be involved in the EP.
Boom, bada, bang, people. So everything is coming together in due time, and that's something to definitely be, you know, happy about, excited about, if you guys are following this band. Also, wanted to say something on this podcast session, you know, whilst we're talking about everything Slaughter the False Prophet. No, it's not meant to be a Warm Shepherd copy, okay? Like, it's really not.
I remember everybody bitching in the comments saying, holy shit, you're a fucking Warm Shepherd copy.
And dude, I seriously remember when me and Devin were talking about, like, the let's see, Warm Shepherd being a Lorna Shore copy, and that was a whole fucking thing.
Fuck.
It's silly.
Nowhere near a copy of Lorna Shore, hell no.
Exactly. And I mean, even better, Adam D'Amico himself was in their Facebook comments basically saying, I mean, y'all are really cool, and it's cool to have you guys compared to us. But yeah, no, you're doing your own thing. And I'm like, that's how it should be. No matter what, that's how it should be. So now we branch down to Slaughter the False Prophet is a Worm Shepherd copy. Just because he's wearing corpse paint does not mean it's a fucking Warner Shore copy. Because I'm planning to do corpse paint, punk. Like, get real, get with the program, man.
I mean, hey, the first thing that drawed me to Devin was the corpse paint. I see corpse paint, I'll watch it, I fucking loved it. And the first thing I found of him was the Frozen Lake.
The Frozen Lake.
From there on forth, I kept talking to the guy, and we got to know each other. Well, we don't know each other. We're not like close. But he knows who I am.
Exactly. And that means that basically, I think over time, I can easily see this like massive brotherhood being woven among all these different bands. You got Nithful, you got Warm Shepherd, Slaughter the False Prophet, The Breathing Process, hint, hint. And there are plenty of others, which is cool. What's up, Dakota?
I was just saying, The Breathing Process is really sick, by the way.
Yeah, we've had them on the podcast before, and they were really good people. Yes, sir. What were you saying, Maleficus, or what were you going to say?
I was about to say that he even like shouted out the band before the exact night before Forsaken was released. He gave us a shout out on Instagram.
Yeah.
Oh shit! Exactly. I didn't know that.
Hell yeah! Shameless plug, people. And this is the future. There's a big community, I feel, that's festering and developing under the skin of the earth and in the underground heavy music community, and that's what we're a part of, man. That's the movement that's going on. It's going to take a little bit, but it will happen in due time, and it will rupture, and nobody will fucking expect it, especially this year. It's going to be really cool for underground heavy music. But Maleficus, my friend, I think it is time for us to begin conversation about Malbolga and the Facebook community that we are making for Slaughter the False Prophet. Basically, any information that we have yet to unfold onto Slaughter the False Prophet's fans, as well as the Sean Cross fans, and you know, everybody subscribed. What are your first thoughts? What are your intentions with this community?
I say for this community, for all of us to come together to enjoy brutal ass fucking music and hating the world as we know.
Hating the world. Yep. And yeah, to say the least, we are going to be getting that opened up as soon as possible. Same as I did with Druid House for Warm Shepherd. I will be acting as the watcher, the overseer for this as well. It's just I got a different title. Because I want to spice it up a little bit. That way y'all don't know who it is. But I mean, if you're listening to this podcast session, you will know who it is. So spoiler alert. But we will be getting that started as soon as possible. And I think with that being said, Maleficus, did you want to give the fans a preview of any new content, any new music for Slaughter the False Prophet? Yes,
I did.
You did. So yeah, here you go, folks. As soon as he pulls it up, we got ourselves a little bit of a podcast exclusive preview of New Slaughter the False Prophet. And for
especially right before the fucking EP releases.
Exactly. And I'm really excited to be a part of this as well. This is a new thing. Really humbled that we were able
to. That is too.
I am as well. Like, this is going to be really cool. I haven't heard anything, so this is brand new to me as well. And yeah, Malbolga, long live Malbolga. And I mean, we are born of Abaddon in Malbolga. So,
totally not Malbolga in fucking
Malbolga.
What I hear about my bulge? What?
Damn it. That's going to be a typo now. That's going to be a meme now.
I made a meme. I have.
You made a meme about the community you're being a part of.
I love it. Oh, boy. Oh my God.
That's going to be a good start. We have to post that meme as soon as we start.
We do.
Yes, Daddy.
That and the fucking 3 Alex 1 Dakota bullshit. Like, yeah. I can't help but
Dakota put that out there. Memes out this bitch here, dude.
That's legit.
Like, we hate humanity, but also, you want to see my bulge? Like,
what the fuck? This motherfucker Dakota is making memes out of this shit, dude.
Oh yeah.
With that, I'm not even trying either. That's the
no,
point.
You're not.
I can't wait to tour with this motherfucker, man.
Yo, did y'all know though that Body Snatcher is actually 3 Kyles and 1 Chris?
Oh shit. Fuck?
Yeah.
Oh shit, this is gonna be weird.
I didn't know that yet. I love Body Snatcher. Like,
weird. Body Snatcher is sick. Yeah. Also, big shout out to their next record coming out later this year. I think in April. It's like Bleed Bite or whatever. And to be honest, it's what I like is that, like a lot of other bands in the scene, they're taking more of that painting approach with their album cover. So they got like this big old freaking colorful landscape, very similar to, I would compare to Luciferus, Enterprise of Earth's Luciferus. But then got this like black solid silhouette on the cliff, and that's it. And I really like it, and I have yet to breathe to it, but we'll get to that when we can. So now the drum roll for New Slaughter the False Prophet.
Let me know if y'all can hear us.
Zoom suppressing the sound from the microphone.
It could be Zoom.
Yeah, it's probably Zoom itself.
So if anything,
I'll send the audio file to you, and after, I guess I'll find a random fucking picture on in the internet.
We'll probably just put the Malbolga sigil over that, and like that will be just at the end of the video. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, it is currently 6:55 p.m. It is February 23rd. We just shared episode 17 of the Anatomy Podcast here in 2022. With none other than Alex Sevenier, Alexander Malefakos, and Dakota, all from Slaughter the False Prophet, a new emerging project alongside, you know, other bands like Mythful and Disembodied Tyrant, and, you know,
I love continue. Those guys.
Yeah, they're really dope. And this definitely is a scene that is growing and emerging from the woodwork. And therefore, we shall continue to emerge. We shall continue to expand, and you guys will be seeing it all here on the Sean Cross channel. Make sure to subscribe. That way you get as many updates as possible as time progresses and as more updates, valid updates, present themselves. But I am Sean Cross, your host, and I do appreciate you guys stopping by tonight. Thank you, gentlemen, also for stopping by tonight. It was a pleasure to finally get this session done, and we will be in contact.
Hell yeah.
Awesome. Hell yeah. Yeah, thanks for having us, dude. It's always a pleasure, and hope I can be back on sometime again soon.
We'll definitely have you on sometime again.
Hell yeah.
All with Alex, the real Alex here. The main. Yeah.
All right. Oh, yeah, for
appreciate
sure, guys.
You.